How many guards are enough? Enough for what? Enough to protect a museum. Now, museums come in all shapes and forms, but we'll restrict our attention to one floor of a museum, and in particular, floor plans where the walls form a polygon. Let's make two assumptions about the guards. One, they can watch in all directions, but two, they remain stationary. Now, clearly placing a guard at each corner lets them watch the entire floor. After all, wherever you're standing, you can see a corner, thus a guard at that corner can see you. But that's a lot of guards. Can we get away with fewer? The remarkable art gallery theorem, sometimes called the museum theorem, claims that if there are n corners, then the number of guards needed is no more than n over 3. The proof places guards in only some of the corners of the polygon. Mathematician Steve Fisk produced a simple and beautiful proof of this theorem in 1978 while dozing off on a bus in Afghanistan. Two things to keep in mind. The theorem says we need no more than n over 3 guards. In many cases, fewer guards are sufficient. An extreme example is a convex polygon with n sides. It only requires one guard. This polygon with 6 triangular sections, known as Schwadl's comb, has 18 corners and requires 6 guards. No matter how many of these triangular sections we have, we will always need one guard for each section and have 3 times as many corners. This shows that the art gallery theorem cannot be made any stronger. How does the proof work? First, triangulate the region, that is, add extra edges between the corners of the polygon so that each subregion is a triangle. Triangulating a region is always possible. Next, color each corner either blue, green, or yellow. Notice that we choose the colors so that each triangle has exactly one of each color for its corners. Such a coloring is also always possible. Now choose one of these colors, say blue. Since each triangle has a blue corner, placing guards at these points guarantees that each triangle, and thus the whole gallery, is being watched. But the same argument could be made for the yellow corners as well as the green corners. In this example, we have 10 blues, 11 yellows, and 7 greens for a total of 28 corners. By placing guards at the 7 green corners, less than 1/3 of the corners are needed to observe the whole museum. In general, if the color which is least used has more than n over 3 corners, then there are more than n over 3 blues, n over 3 yellows, and n over 3 greens, totaling more than n corners, a contradiction. This proves that there is at least one color with no more than n over 3 corners, and so we have proven the art gallery theorem. A nice extension of the previous proof applies to orthogonal polygons, that is, polygons where all of the interior angles are either 90 degrees or 270 degrees. If there are n corners, the orthogonal art gallery theorem claims that at most n over 4 guards are enough to protect the gallery. This proof is similar to before, but instead of dissecting the gallery into triangles, we dissect it into convex quadrilaterals. The corners can then be colored with 4 colors such that each quadrilateral uses each color exactly once. The same logic as before applies to complete the proof. Many other results like the art gallery theorem have been produced, but let me leave you with a problem to think about. In the previous layout, we could have placed the guards at these 5 points. This inspires what I will call the lonely guard conjecture. Is it always possible to place the guards at corners to see the whole museum, but no guard sees another? Think about it.